The development by the minister comes a day after the president assented to the NSSF Amendment Bill 2021, occurring 20% meter maxes to some of the members above 40 years and have served for more than 10 years. Minister Betty Amongin says it's true, those who have been saving will have to get part of their savings, but they ought to be patient until this act is fully implemented. For its full implementation, it will have to go through some steps, including the act coming into force upon publication in the Uganda Gazette. The minister will have to first issue statutory instrument to guide on the terms and conditions and procedures for accessing benefits.
I think most people fear the way maybe it will be complicated for them to access the fund. That's why we are saying within the days we have been given to come up with the regulations, I want to appeal to those who are representative of these organizations. I read some of their names. The organizations and stakeholders, we are going to engage you so that you make a contribution on the most easy applicable terms, conditions, and procedure for accessing the midterm access. Usually, most of the workers or people who are in rural area fear that the terms will be too stringent, that they will not end up getting the money.
She further clarified on the categories of members who are eligible for the midterm access to the benefits.
The midterm access is discretionary to the worker. It is meant for those who feel that they have a critical problem that cannot wait for the 55 years. That's why we said, okay, we had other terms and conditions within which you can access your money previously. But because of COVID-19 pandemic, a lot of interruption in people's income has occurred. So let's allow those who are below 55 who would want to access their fund a provision in the law that will mandate them to access. However, this particular midterm access is not mandatory. That's why the statutory instrument will spell out how to apply. You will apply for it, and if you do not apply for it, your money will remain up to the time that you want it.
According to Peter Chemboa, the chairperson of the NSSF board, they plan to give out over 900 billion shillings to over 90,000 beneficiaries who are eligible for the midterm access. He re-emphasized the readiness of the fund to start giving out the funds to the beneficiaries once the procedures by the Minister of Gender are completed.
The bill into law, that's already a major impact. Our job is to prove that we as Ugandans, we can be as efficient as possible and effective too in our systems. NSSF is one of the most technologically enabled and data-driven enterprise in this country. So in terms of efficiency, in terms of safety and flexibility, all the guarantees we are providing them. So whatever the minister said is what we are moving with, and we are going to build on this. Communication is going to be consistent and regular from now on.
The amendment of the NSSF Act has also given immense opportunities to the workers. For example, every worker is now eligible to save with the fund. Every employer is now obliged to contribute to the NSSF for their workers, irrespective of the number employed. Every worker can save with the fund over and above the mandatory 15% contributions, among others. Yesterday, the president assented to the NSSF bill, news that sent workers union into celebrations. A story by Jeliet Namwaya for the news.